Hi friends, welcome to my channel. In this video we are going to see that what is the scope of qualifying the UG SENET in JRF and assistant professor and only in the assistant professor alone in future. Before going into the main content of this video, here one small announcement is that the Unacademy is providing the complete course for the UG SENET paper 1 as well as the paper 2 electronic science, and the details regarding this course is provided at the end of this video. Hi friends, welcome to my channel. My name is Ashwani Kumar, an academy educator for the subject NTA UG SENET Electronic Science as well as the general paper 1. If you are not yet subscribed to the channel, then please do subscribe and then click on the bell icon. Then you are going to get all my updates and videos as the immediate notifications to your devices. I started one Facebook account, guys. So, and I provided this link in the description box of this video. So please join into this group. So here the group name is Your Mentor, just same as this YouTube channel name. So in this group also, here all the advertisements regarding the assistant professor, teachers and the PhD notifications I posted here. So you will get, or else you will be having a look on all the posts at a glance here. Okay, so join into this group that I provided the link in the description box. And now while coming to the present content of the video, so generally if you are writing the UG SENET exam means, so you will be having the two points in your mind, that getting the job as assistant professor in the universities. We will discuss about the colleges separately. So right now I'm talking about only the state and the central universities. Okay. So the two points will be there in your mind, that one is getting the job as assistant professor in the universities, and the second one is getting the PhD seats from the very good colleges or the institutes or the universities. Okay, so these two points will be there in your mind. So the third point is also there, that came into existence from the past 2 to 3 years. What is the third point is that based upon the UG SENET qualification, central government, that is just like the ONGC, okay, and DRDO are announcing few jobs, okay, mostly based upon the management related subjects. Okay, so but the scope of getting the government jobs is very, very less. So we can say almost some 2% or 3% like that. And coming to the assistant professor means, so if you are applying for the assistant professor in any one university, the PhD candidates also will apply to that one. And if you see the criteria, so it is a shortlisting criteria of the candidates for interview of the post of assistant professor in the universities. So if you look at this criteria, and you can check down the graduation, post graduation, MPhil, PhD. And so if you look at here, PhD candidates is getting the 30 marks, NET with JRF candidates getting the 7 marks, NET candidates are getting the 5 marks, SLET or SET candidates getting the 3 marks. Okay. So here, if for the assistant professor vacancies, if the PhD candidates are applied, then definitely there will be a very, very tough competition to the NET qualified candidates, and the scope of getting the assistant professor job in the universities will be very, very less based upon your UG SENET qualification. Okay, but because here the PhD qualified candidates are having the more weightage comparing with the NET qualified candidates. And while coming to the assistant professor, we are having the different levels like level 10, 11 and 12. So all these three levels are comes under the assistant professor levels category. So coming to the level 10 is the basic entry. Okay, level 10 is the entry level of the assistant professor in the universities. So as per the UGC regulations 2018, for this level 10 category, the UG SENET qualified candidates can apply and the PhD candidates can able to apply. But here the PhD candidates are having the more scope, more marks comparing with the NET qualified candidates. Okay, so it is a one point. So from this concept, what you have to understand is that with UG SENET qualification, trying for assistant professor jobs in the universities and the competition with the PhD candidates will be very, very difficult. So there is a less chance you will be having to get the assistant professor jobs in the universities based upon your NET qualification. Okay, so it is the first point. And while coming to the next one, that is the PhD. So if you are trying for the PhD admissions in the very good institutes, just like the IITs, NITs and IIITs, okay, central universities and state universities. So for the PhD, seat, okay, for getting the PhD admission, your UGC NET qualification will be mostly helpful comparing with the assistant professor in universities and government jobs based upon the very few less jobs will be there. Okay. So finally, what I want to conclude my video is that with UGC NET qualification, you can try for the PhD admission and assistant professor seats and for the government jobs, just like the PSUs. Okay, the PSUs or the government jobs are very less, okay, very, very less, hardly some 5-3% will be like that. And if you want to get the assistant professor jobs in the universities, then the PhD candidates will definitely give some competition. Okay, unless and until if you are not having the sound research publications, then it will be very difficult. And getting the PhD admission is a very, very, very easy task based upon your NET qualification. That means if you qualified the UGC NET, most of the chances will be there to get the PhD admission in very good universities or the colleges comparing with the assistant professor and the PSUs like that. Okay. So it is a conclusion that what I want to give. And coming from the 2021 onwards, the MHRD already gave one notice in the 2018 regulations itself that from 2021 June onwards, the PhD is mandatory for the universities. Okay, so if they made PhD mandatory for the universities, then with based upon the UGC NET qualification, one more option will be gone away, that is for applying the assistant professor in the universities. Then if this rule came into existence, then the UGC NET qualified candidates can able to apply assistant professors only in the affiliated colleges. Okay, so not even the deemed universities or the private universities. Okay, still now itself, the deemed and private universities, state and central government universities are taking the minimum PhD qualified candidates. Okay, I mean, most of the universities are taking the PhD qualified candidates. Very few are giving the announcements regarding the UGC NET qualification based assistant professor vacancies, that is level 10. Okay, so based upon this one, you have to think about yourself. Okay, I think you understood about the scope of the UGC NET in future. Okay, and from 2021 onwards, if the rule is came into existence, then definitely you can't, the UGC NET qualified candidates cannot able to apply for the universities also. You have to apply only for the colleges. Okay, so for it is a content that I want to tell you guys, because most of my subscribers are asking in the comment sections that what about the UGC NET in future. So based upon my experience, I am doing this video. So please, if you like this one, please share to your friends or colleagues, and please subscribe the channel to get the more notifications, and after subscribing, tap the bell icon. And the candidates who are preparing for the UGC NET exam, here an announcement follows, so please listen guys. Hi friends, my name is Ashwini Kumar, Unacademy educator. So all of you know that Unacademy is India's largest learning platform, and it is providing the very good content to the learners who are preparing for the competitive examinations. And from this video, I want to bring you one notice that I am going to start the two new courses for the UGC NET candidates who are preparing for the UGC NET exam in 2021. So the course number one is complete course for the NTA UGC NET paper 1, that is teaching and research aptitude. So that it is going to start from November 9th onwards. And coming to the paper 2 is electronic science. So the complete course for the electronic science is going to start from November 10th onwards. So the interested candidates may take the subscription plan of the Unacademy, that I will show you the different types of subscription plans. But before going to those subscription plans for the paper 1 and as well as to the paper 2, one thing that I want to share you is that if you want to check how the lectures will be, and why, because each and everybody is having some dilemma that before taking the subscription plans, that whatever the content I am going to teach you, so how the content I'm going to give you, so whether you can able to understand or not. So for that purpose, I will provide my Unacademy profile link in the description box of this video guys. So if you click on that one, then you will be directed to this web page. So here, if you scroll down, you can check the special classes. So special classes means these are the completely free classes. So every month I'm going to take the free classes to the candidates. So if you click on this see all, then all my special classes that you can check down here, right? So if you click on these classes, then whatever the video classes I took at that date and time, so those videos will play. So with the help of these videos, you can decide that how I am going to deliver the content of the concepts and each and everything. So based upon that one, you may take the subscription plans, guys. Okay. And if you want to check that how I am going to teach the UGCNET paper 1, that is Teaching and Research Aptitude. So it is my official YouTube channel link for the paper 1 that you can check down. I will provide this link also in the description box of this video. So here I did the complete unit 1, that is the teaching aptitude here by taking the total 6 parts. So it will be acts like the reference to you that how I am going to teach you, whether you can able to understand or not. So by looking all this content, that means the electronic science from the Unacademy app and from the YouTube channel, you can guess that how I am going to teach the paper 1. So by looking all these things, you can decide whether to take the subscription plan and whether I am going to explain as per your understanding levels or not. So these are the different subscription plans, guys. That means for 1 month, 3 months, 6 months, 12 months and 24 months. So depending upon your goal, that means when you want to write the exam, so based upon that one, you may take any one of the subscription plans that it is showing on your screens. But one thing is that if you are planning to take the subscription plan for both paper 1 as well as for the electronic science, then use my referral code, that is Aswini K, right? So it is my referral code, guys, ASWINIK, and you are going to get the 10% discount on any one of the subscription plan. Okay, so it is the information that I want to deliver from this video through my channel. And if you want to know about the previous courses feedbacks, that you can click down here. So these are all the dedications given by the previous batch students. So you may check down the different feedbacks here. Okay, so the candidates who are preparing for the UGCNET exam in the 2021. So the both the UGCNET paper 1 and the electronic science, so both these two course will definitely helpful to you to crack the JRF. Fine, guys. So please share this information to your friends or colleagues who are preparing for the UGCNET exam in the next sessions. And all the best, guys. Thank you very much.